Most people attribute the invention of the firearm to Europe, but this is false. China invented both gunpowder and firearms. Gunpowder was invented in the 7th century China by Chinese alchemists searching for an elixir for immortality. But experiments with saltpeter may predate even this. Gunpowder is one of the four great inventions of China and consists primarily of three components: sulfur, charcoal, and potassium nitrate, also known as saltpeter. The sulfur and charcoal act as fuels, or reducers, while the saltpeter acts as an oxidizer. The combustion of gunpowder is known as deflagration, which is a subsonic explosion, which contrasts with detonation, which is a supersonic explosion. The slower propagation of deflagration allows controlled explosions to propel projectiles contained in the vessel without destroying the vessel in the process. A lot of people assume that China invented gunpowder but only used it in fireworks or firecrackers, while Europe invented firearms. This, of course, is wrong, as the Chinese quickly learned the destructive potential of gunpowder in warfare. The exact date when firearms were invented is uncertain, but the earliest known representation of a gun comes from the 10th century silk banner from Dunhuang. Another early depiction of a firearm comes from a sculpture in a cave in Sichuan, China, that has been dated to the 12th century and clearly depicts a projectile being fired from a bombard. The predecessor to the firearm was the fire lance, which were weapons consisting of a bamboo tube which contained gunpowder and projectiles along with a spear. When fired, the weapon would emit flames, shrapnel, and project a spear out to a range of only a few feet. The weapon was intended to give a soldier an edge in close-quarter combat and was recorded being used in the siege of Dian in 1132 by Song forces against the Jurchens. The fire lance was eventually replaced by the hand cannon, one of the earliest forms of firearms. The design consisted of a barrel that was made out of either bamboo or metal, and sometimes attached to a wooden stock. The weapon was usually fired by two people, with one person bracing the hand cannon, while the other loaded and ignited the gunpowder. The hand cannon could fire rocks or pre-made iron or stone projectiles. Range and accuracy was poor, and early hand cannon was not capable of penetrating armor reliably. However, the weapon was cheap and easy to mass-produce. Eventually, the hand cannon evolved into the matchlock musket. The new weapon was much smaller and lighter and could be fired by a single person, greatly improving the mobility of the soldier carrying it. The basic mechanism of the matchlock remains unchanged from the hand cannon. A soldier would load the barrel with gunpowder, a projectile, and wadding. Then he would ignite gunpowder near the breech with a slow-burning match cord. Muskets were used in the Ming Dynasty between 1368 to 1644. In addition to firearms, the Chinese also invented rockets. An early form of gunpowder-based rocket was the fire arrow. Early designs consisted of a pouch of gunpowder with a stick attached. The rocket would then be fired from a stand, usually made of bamboo. The stick was used to provide stability to the rocket in flight, and were launched in salvos of as many as 1,000 rockets at a time, and had a range of 1,000 feet while having an explosive tip made of pitch or resin. Fire arrows were first reported to be used during the siege of Yuzhong by the southern Wu in 904. The Mongols eventually encountered the weapon during their invasions of China and subsequently employed it themselves during their invasions of Japan and their military campaigns in the Middle East. It is uncertain of how exactly gunpowder and firearms were introduced to Europe, but most historians accept that the Islamic world was introduced to both gunpowder and firearms before Europe. One theory suggests that gunpowder was introduced to Europe from the Middle East through the Silk Road. However, others believe that Europe was exposed to firearms during the Mongol invasions of Europe. One of the earliest uses of gunpowder-based weapons against European powers was in the Battle of Mohi, where Mongol forces won a decisive victory against the Kingdom of Hungary and their allies. Firearms may have disseminated into Europe during the subsequent Franco-Mongol alliance, and William Rubruck, who was an ambassador to the Mongols in 1254 to 1255, may have been the intermediary for which gunpowder formulation and gunsmithing entered Europe. So now you know better, and that was Enigma Hood's Common Misconceptions.